My friend, if there is one thing that we are constantly and consistently learning, it is the power of discipline and how freedom can actually come from being disciplined. How, when we are disciplined, we are not in limitation, but in liberation. How do I know this? There is a quotation that I had never heard before this year, but it started to make complete sense. The quote reads, "He who cannot obey himself will be commanded." The one who cannot obey themselves will be commanded. And if you think really hard about this quote, is it not so true? If we cannot obey ourselves of what we want to do in life, there are others who line up to command us with a dream, falling into their plan. They television and we watch as we live vicariously through them and have our own visions told, instead, if you wish to live a free life, choose the life of discipline and see what you get. Had a wonderful interview and spoke with Julia Ferreira, who lives in Switzerland. She has now over 1 year been living a raw vegan lifestyle, consuming no animal products, no meat, no cheese, but also for 7 days she consumed nothing but oranges, orange juice, and it has now been over 25 days that she has been on a monofruit diet of nothing but watermelon. Consuming watermelon day in and day out. Speaking with Julia was transformative, not only for me, but for the onlookers, for the people who were able to hear the message from her. Having the wonderful French accent, being in that part of Switzerland, she is free. Free to roam, go out in nature, free to do whatever she wishes. More free than most people I know. Because it is said that those who do not move do not notice their chains. And the chains of habit are too light to be felt until they are too heavy to be broken. She stated to me that at first, you start playing mind games with yourself. When you are undergoing a new discipline, the first few days you think to yourself, oh, I feel like I should live a little. Life is meant to be enjoyed. Let me eat this, eat that. Let me do this, do that. But once you get through those first few days and you chart a course that has no end destination, the world opens up for you. Limitation, or what others see as limitation, becomes liberating for you. It frees you up from useless decision making, the psychic energy that would be taken up by, should I do this, should I do that? Would I do this? Would I do that? Could I do this? Could I do that? Instead, the decision has already been made, and you have so much more room in your mind for other decisions to be made. When you reduce your consumption to one thing, the world can open up for you in ways you could only imagine. And through this discipline, it can be very freeing on a level that you never thought possible. But if you cannot obey yourself, odds are you will be commanded. If not by someone else, maybe even by your own mind. A prisoner in your own body, swayed this way and that by the thoughts and radio stations that you pick up from outside, unable to fend for yourself, unable to live for yourself, unable to act on your own. But when you can obey yourself, you command your body. You tell yourself when to stand up, when to sit down, when to move forward, when to retire. You realize that you are the one that is in the control seat of your life. And though outside circumstances may happen beyond the realm of your control, you can always control your reaction to them. Thus, by doing this, you put yourself back on the throne in your kingdom. Or queendom. Able to have command over yourself as though you were one of your loyal subjects. Not a deserter or a foreign element in your kingdom. My friend, with a love like this for yourself, loving yourself enough to be disciplined, the whole world belongs to you. Thank you for listening, my friend. This has been Jerome Shaw on TOP, the Open Palm Podcast here in Columbia, South Carolina. I trust you received an encouraging message letting you know that certain perceptions on freedom and what it means to be liberated may differ. You give yourself a try at a new lifestyle and see what things come up for you. Share this with someone who needs to hear it. And if this is your first time receiving this podcast, subscribe for messages like this. If you'd like to support, head to anchor.fm/jshaw. Clicking the support button there is much appreciated. Thank you to all the supporters who continue to donate, making it possible for episodes like this. Have a blessed day or night, wherever you are, my friend. And as always, take care.